Hey y'all, I'm Rylan. Welcome to my channel. Today, on February 25th, I'm starting a reading vlog for the book I Let You Go by Claire McIntosh. I did not get to my original book for my 12 and 12 challenge. Yikes, I'm trying it again in March, but I did desperately want to stay on top of that challenge, so I switched Crescent City or House of Earth and Blood, which is what I was originally planning to read this month. I switched it for I Let You Go. This is a thriller, and I just dropped it. Very short, or not super short, I guess, but shorter than Crescent City would have been. I desperately, desperately, desperately want to stay on top of this challenge. I want to be able to get a vlog up for one book on that challenge every month. So this is my second book for the 12 and 12 challenge. The first book that I read was Behind Her Eyes by Sarah Pinborough. If you want to watch my vlog on that book, I will have it tagged above and in the description down below. This is a thriller. No idea what it's about, but it was recommended to me by my aunt. So I have very high hopes for it. She loved this book. This book got her into thrillers, and when I saw it last year at some point at Books and Company for like $4, I went ahead and grabbed it because my aunt had been raving about this book for a long time. So I'm finally reading it. She doesn't know that I'm reading it, but I will tell her when I finish it because every time we talk about books, this one comes up and she just really wants me to finally read it. So I'm reading it. My goal is to binge this book in 3 days. Today is the 25th, I guess 4 days, I guess, kind of. 25th, 26th, 27th, and the 28th. So my goal is to finish this one by Monday. It is Friday right now, and I have the audiobook. So if I can listen to 25% of this book each day, then I will easily be able to finish it by Monday night. When I know what this book is about, I will let you all know. I have been struggling this month to get to all the books on my TBR. I've read a lot, but I have added books for reasons like book tours or other stuff that have caused me to push off some of the other reading plans that I had for this month. Not that I'm complaining, I have loved what I've read a lot of, but I am just trying to stay consistent and follow through on these challenges that I started for myself. So I want to binge this book really fast. I can probably do it. I don't see why I couldn't do it. All I have to do this weekend is homework. I have a very big project due on Monday, but I should be fine. Not extremely worried about it, kind of. Anyway, regardless, I'm not gonna talk about it. But anyway, yes, I've just been kind of rambling. Now, I'll be starting I Let You Go today. I have the audiobook on Libby, so I'll be listening to it on there. I have very high hopes for this book. My aunt loved it, and we seem to enjoy a lot of the same thrillers. So I'm going into this one without knowing anything, but I cannot wait to get to it. I am excited to talk to my aunt about the book once I finish it and let her know my thoughts on it. I will hop back on here when I am 50% of the way through this one. Maybe I will update before then, since I am doing just one book for this vlog. I don't know, I'll figure it out. I'll hop back on when I feel like it, I guess, and let you all know what this one is about. Hopefully I love it. I know my aunt did, so I'm excited to dive into it today. It has been almost a week since I started this vlog, and I am only 35% of the way through I Let You Go. Reading just hasn't happened during this last week. I DNF'd a book, haven't finished anything else since I DNF'd that book. I have been juggling to finish up final projects and exams for my first two online classes that are finally done. Yay, I have 10 days or so off school before my next set of online classes starts. So I am taking full advantage of that break. I plan to get a lot of videos filmed. I would like to get a ton of reading done. I'm doing a readathon this month that starts in 5 days. I think it starts next Monday. So hopefully, yeah, I can just get a lot of stuff done while I'm not in school, kind of find my groove again because I'm just feeling very burnt out right now. But I did just want to hop on here and share a little bit about what this book is about because I am far enough along into it that I can tell you that now. And because this vlog is only for one book, I figured, you know, might as well update you all now. I Let You Go is about a mom named Jenna. Yeah, Jenna, whose son dies in a hit and run. Happens in the very first chapter or prologue or whatever. And she ends up running away from her home when the police do not find out, or they cannot find out who killed her son. And apparently she has a past that we don't really know much about. Lots of secrets and lots of really tough times. And I know that the book is about like her painful past coming back and like haunting her again. I don't know. She's in hiding right now. She is in this coastal town, I think. And yeah, like doesn't have a phone. Like it's very just cut off from the world. So we get her chapters. Yeah, we get to kind of follow her as she, yeah, is experiencing this grief and this loss a year after her son's death. And yeah, how she's just running away from that whole situation. And then in the other chapters, we follow a detective or a policeman named Ray, and him and his partner, Kate, I think are their names. They are no longer working on the case actively because it's been a year, you know, and they're not allowed to anymore. Basically, like their supervisor was like, look, we're not gonna find out what happened and it sucks, but we have more cases that you need to solve. So that's one of the back burner. Maybe, you know, come back to it at a later time, whatever. But Ray and Kate, they're like, we don't like that. So we're going to continue working on the case in secret, you know, after hours when we can just, yeah, like focus on that case away from the prying eyes of the police force. And yeah, that's basically what this book is about. I'm not like obsessed with it. I'm not, but I'm enjoying it. I don't tend to read thrillers that have like the police investigator, you know, the police force like involved. Yeah, like I don't read a lot of thrillers that have those characters in them. So I kind of like getting both. I don't tend to gravitate toward like police procedural books. I just, not my style when it comes to thrillers for whatever reason. No good reason, it's just not what I gravitate toward. I love domestic thrillers and things like that versus this. But not that police can't be in those other types of thrillers. But anyway. Yeah, I'm enjoying it, not loving it, but I'm expecting some great things because my aunt is literally obsessed with this book. And yeah. Is super excited that I'm finally reading it, so we'll see what happens. I have nothing to do today aside from filming some videos and reading because that's what I'm gonna do today. That's what I'm gonna do for the next 10 days. Cannot wait. Anyway, hopefully, maybe I can finish this book by tonight. I highly doubt it, but we'll see if I can. I don't know. We'll see what happens. But yeah, I will update you all again when I am probably 60% of the way through, you know, kind of cut it into 3 sections. We'll see if anything big or interesting happens. I don't know. I don't know what to expect. Yeah, but I will let you all know. And yeah, I will update you all on how I'm feeling. So I went ahead and binged the entirety of I Let You Go the night after I did my second vlog update or my first vlog update, depending on how you look at it. Didn't feel like stopping to do an update at 60%. I just couldn't stop reading it, or I couldn't stop listening to it at that point because it was so good. I do want to say that my synopsis of the book in the last clip is not completely accurate. That is what I was led to believe as I read the first 30% of the book. It is misleading on purpose. It helps with the twist that comes a little bit later. So I'm not updating or editing my synopsis at all. What I said the book is about is what you think the book is about. until it's not what the book is about. And I thought it was truly amazing. I did give this book 4 stars. It is not my favorite thriller. It took me a very long time to get through the first 30% of this one. And yeah, I wasn't a huge fan of it in the beginning. It was just a very slow start for me. But once we hit that first plot twist, I was hooked. I do just want to mention a couple of trigger warnings for this book. There is domestic abuse between a husband and wife in this book. There is some pretty graphic violence and physical violence in this one as well. I was not expecting that when I picked this book up, so I just wanted to throw it out there and let you all know that there are definitely some trigger warnings for this book if you haven't already read it and do want to read it at some point. But overall, yeah, wonderful book, super gritty and captivating, and I feel like I use that word in all of my vlogs or review videos, but it really was. Like, I was so into this book once I reached a certain point in it, and I couldn't put it down. And I'm so glad that my aunt finally got it in my head enough to pick it up. She'd been telling me to read this for over a year now, and I'm like, oh yeah, I'll get to it. Yeah, it finally stuck this time, and I finally got to it, and I'm so glad that I did. This was the second book on my 12 and 12 challenge, technically for the month of February, but I didn't finish it until March. So we're not going to talk about it. We're going to pretend that I am on track still for this challenge, because I am. We're not behind yet. This vlog isn't amazing. I'm not going to lie. It's not the best vlog ever. But I did say in my 12 and 12 challenge video that I would do a review, not a review, a vlog for every book on my 12 and 12 challenge. And I am determined to follow through on that thing that I said. So this is my second vlog for that challenge. Had a really enjoyable time reading this book. It did take me a while to get into it, but there are so many twists that just kept coming that I wasn't expecting, and I couldn't put the book down once I finally got into it. I would definitely recommend checking I Let You Go out if you haven't picked this one up already. I should have read this one sooner. I kept pushing it off, so I'm glad I finally read this one for this challenge this year. This is not a super exciting vlog, but it's a vlog regardless. Thank you all so much for watching it, and I will see you all in the next video.